The following program does not necessarily represent the views of the Trinity Broadcasting Network.
Edition of Joy in Our Town. I'm Ann Farrell Tata, your host, and today I'm delighted to welcome my guests, Aisley, Bosier, and Trevor Lucas. And our issue today is youth, and we're going to be talking about self-esteem. And Aisley is a young author, and she has written a book, Aisley Says, I Am Not the Hair I Wear. So welcome both of you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So Aisley, tell us a little bit about yourself and where you came from, where you live, where you go to school.
My name is Aisley Bosier, and I am a 12-year-old author, and I am a seventh grader. I'm an ordinary girl. I'm the second oldest of five children, and I just serve the Lord.
And so you have, you go to middle school, seventh grade, and you have had some experience with self-esteem issues. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, I was growing up, as I still am, and there were people who thought badly about me and said different things about me, whether it was my hair, the clothes I wear, or the way I speak, or the way I walk, or it was just all types of things. And it's just, that's just what it was. People were saying bad comments, and I would talk to my mom and get more encouragement and empower from her.
And this started when you were really young, and this was in school?
Yeah, this started, well, all my life, even from administrators. It's nothing new, and I'm pretty sure there's going to be more in this lifetime. Well, as I grow up, there's going to be more and more comments.
Well, how did you overcome this, and how did you, I know you said your mom helped you, but what kind of things did you do to get more confident and not let these hurtful things bother you?
Well, for starters, I had to pray to the Lord and start reading scriptures, and my parents would help me more and tell me more about how God made me in His own image and His likeness, as He did everybody else, and I shouldn't be ashamed of how I look or any of my traits just because what other people say.
And just out of curiosity, you're from a big family. What impact did your siblings have? Did they help you, or were they experiencing some of the same things?
Yeah, my sister and my brother, they experienced it too. So, and we're family, so that's how I overcome, because I know I'm not alone, and I always have family to lean on and talk to and overcome things.
Well, and then you decided to write a book, Aisley Says, I Am Not the Hair I Wear. Tell us a little bit about your book and how that came about.
I decided to write that book because I know there's other kids, smaller, older, and even adults who go through the same thing, if not worse. And I know it was a terrible experience for me, myself. And so I wanted other people to get the message and know that it's okay to be yourself and just get the point across that we're all made from God in His own image. And we shouldn't always be focused on what we look like, because what really matters is what's in the inside.
That's right. That is so true. And you are beautiful, by the way. Anyone's talking about.
Thank you.
So, Trevor, you are the illustrator of this book. Can you tell us a little bit about you and how you came to this project?
Well, I know Aisley's mother, Martinique, and I've always been an artist. You know, I do a lot of other things, but art is my first love. And she knew that, you know, I drew. I wasn't at the time in the middle of any project, so she had asked if I would illustrate her story. And I mean, from hearing what it's about, what the motivation behind it, I couldn't see anything other than to make it happen. So me being a person, of course I'm an artist, but I like to motivate people as well. You know, I think we were all put here for a certain purpose. And you know, yes, I can draw, but if we're gonna use things for God's kingdom, we use those gifts to forward anything that's positive, progressive, and to show who he is, you know, and I think that book does that.
Well, it must have been really interesting to have a little girl, you know, hearing her side of it. Mm-hmm. You probably had not even really thought about that. How was that, just, you know, as you got to know Aisley and her story?
Well, actually, I have a daughter.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, she has faced a few things, you know, and I have those conversations. So hearing her story only brings me back to, you know what, Layla deals with that as well.
Right.
So, you know, it's only right as a father to see a child who understands, not only knows about what's happening, but understands
right.
how to deal with it. You know, so it was kind of a breath of fresh air to hear it
yeah.
come from another child. You know, yeah, I go through it, but I'm okay, and we're
right.
gonna write this book and make other kids okay. So
right.
That's basically how I took it, and I had.
Well, and also, it's got to come for you that you're not alone. I mean,
mm-hmm.
you know, his daughter went through it, and so what do you do now when your friends come to you and they are talking about things that are hurtful to them? How do you encourage them?
Well, for starters, I encourage them to pray and ask the Lord about it and read the same scriptures that I had to read in order to believe and have confidence in myself. And I give them compliments and let them know that they're awesome themselves and tell them about my testimony.
When words, you know, we know that even physical wounds heal, but the hurtful words take so long. Were you able to heal from this experience that you've...
Yeah, I was able to heal from it because I know that these are only challenges that I'm facing while I'm still young, and I still have a long way to go in this lifetime, so I should just move on. And, you know, of course I'm gonna pray about it and ask the Lord about it and lean on my family and even friends sometimes. Real actual friends I'm gonna lean on, and I just move on.
And what do you say? I'm sure you hear people being mean to other people. Do you ever go and talk to them and tell them to cut it out?
Yeah, I did that a lot in my lifetime, and people hate me, and they probably still hate me now.
So, because you're standing up for people, that's
yeah.
great. So what kind of things would you suggest young girls that are facing this the way you have? What would you tell them?
I would tell them that we are all beautiful. We are all here on this planet for a reason. God put us here for a reason. And the last thing we should think about is our looks. We need to worry more about what's on the inside. And there's going to be times when, even though we know that, we're still going to listen to the comments that people give us about our looks and our personalities. But we all should stick together and move on, because the main goal is to go in heaven and be with God.
Well, and how about, like, social media? That has got to play into this. You probably see a lot of things on Instagram and Facebook that, mm-hmm. you know, really are hurtful. How do you handle that?
Social media, it has its own preference itself. Straight hair and short clothes and all that stuff, it has a lot. And mainly, girls are... they just feed onto that, and they try hard and harder and harder to be what the social media wants them to be, when we should look past that and just move on and know that we are our own characters. Each and every one of us, there is no one like us. We're all different.
Now, what are you going to do future-wise? Are you going to get this message out to other people? Because you're so articulate, and you need to share your story.
Yeah, you know, right now I'm trying to get the message out by going to schools and motivating other little girls and students and, you know, just giving them that word to empower them and encourage them.
And Trevor, how will you stay involved with this? Are you going to help her?
Oh, yeah. Well, I see this as being a series of things that could help children. You know, there's so many things that people face, adults as well,
right.
that we constantly need to educate and empower people to get past. And you had mentioned social media. I feel as if media in general, and when you turn on the television, turn on social media, you turn on the radio, we're bombarded with negativity and nonsense. And you're also told what you should look like,
mm-hmm.
What you should wear. This person's cool, this person's not. So it's almost like a social engineering, if you will. Everyone kind of gets their idea of who they should be from media. So I feel like it's very important that we get in that fight of media and show that there's more to this world than just looks, than just having. It's more about being and walking in your purpose and helping everybody come together to do the same thing. So I see a series, I see cartoons, I see all types of things, but we have to get that message out creatively so people will pay attention, because, you know, just talking hasn't done anything. So we have to find other angles.
Well, and don't you think, I mean, oftentimes I think hurt people hurt people. Mm-hmm. So a lot of people, when they are saying these mean things, it's because of things that they're going, you know, things that are going on in their lives, then they're hurt. So, you know, that's why it's such an important message, I mm-hmm. think, because people, you know, everyone comes from brokenness, it mm-hmm. seems. Mm-hmm. So how would you encourage those
people?
Yeah, that are just broken and, well, you know, they're mean, but really there's a reason that they're mean.
Right.
It's because
they,
of their
they
brokenness.
They came up and somebody was doing certain things
right.
to them, and they
right.
just kind of pass it on. You fight those demons. At the end of the day, you know, God told us to let our light so shine.
Yeah.
And they'll know us by our fruit. And like Aisley said, that we were made in God's image. But what's happening is these demons that are being passed on are making us pretty much squander and set aside our inheritance and what we were made to be. So in us living it out,
yeah.
and basically, she's a cute little girl, she's cool, she's articulate, she has a book, she becomes popular now, okay?
Yeah.
So instead of those negative people, it'll happen.
Yeah.
That's what marketing is about. The thing, what's been marketed is the negativity. So if we start marketing and supporting positivity and make that the in crowd, then people just don't want to be alone. You know
right.
what I mean? So if the negativity seems like the cool thing, that's what the kids follow.
Right.
But if that becomes the cool thing, then they have no choice. You know what? I'm going to follow her. She got the crowd around her.
Yeah.
And she's doing good things. It feels good.
Yeah.
And people understand by our fruit and by how we present ourselves that this is a better way to go. Instead of talking you to death, we'll live it out.
Well, and what about boys? Because it seems like girls maybe use
Uh-oh.
Words, but, you mm-hmm. know, how do you, I mean, boys probably, you know, use their fists more, a little more physical.
Boys, they're always going to say something. They're just as bad as the girls. But sometimes boys do that because they like a girl.
Yeah, that's true.
That's
yeah, you got to distinguish
like. Yes.
what the message is.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean they should disrespect them in any type of way.
Yeah.
So you still have to put them in their place when they do that and just... Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So now, what about your siblings? How are they taking your book and everything? Are they supportive? Are they teasing you? I mean, siblings are siblings.
They're supporting. We're actually all working into a team. We're getting our own T-shirts, and it's just a family thing. And we're all getting something out of it, whether it's learning from each other, smiles from each other. We're all getting something out.
Because the boys would have a story, too. I mean, they, mm-hmm. again, they have a different, I mean, growing up, did
yeah.
you experience, you know, self-esteem
oh, yeah.
issues?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And how did you overcome that?
If I want to be totally honest, at first, I tried to fit in.
Yeah.
Because I always felt like I was different. But it took me a little bit later to realize that being different was the great thing, you know?
Yeah.
If everybody has on green shirts and you put a green one on, you kind of blend in, but
right.
with you becoming yourself, that's how you stand out. That's where a lot of, you know, young boys get things mixed up. We just want to be cool, you know?
Right.
So we'll tend to try to fit in, but what we don't understand is you're fitting in. And if you're looking to stand out, acting like everybody else, it doesn't make any sense. So that's what helped
yeah.
me.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing. I think everybody does want to fit in.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that's, you know, we just demonstrate it different ways,
mm-hmm.
but there are so many healthy ways to do that and
Definitely.
Overcome that. So we have been joined by Aisley Bosier and Trevor Lucas, and we're going to take a short break. And when we come back, we're going to continue our conversation, and we're going to get into more some of the bullying things that both of y'all have experienced and how we're helping to overcome that. So thank you so much. And I'm so excited about your book, and I'm excited about your future, because this is a good message that needs to be told.
Yeah.
So I'm Ann Farrell Tata. This is Joy in Our Town. And if you'll just hold on, we'll be right back. Thank you.
Can't do this, you can't do that. The beat us lies, but how far?
Hi, welcome back to this edition of Joy in Our Town. I'm Ann Farrell Tata, your host, and I've been joined by Aisley Bosier and Trevor Lucas. And Aisley is a 12-year-old author. She wrote a book called Aisley Says I Am Not the Hair I Wear. And we've been talking about self-esteem issues and bullying, and we're going to continue get a little deeper into bullying. Now, unfortunately, you have been bullied. So can you tell us a little bit about your experience and what happened?
Well, I've been bullied from when I was just really, really small. I couldn't really understand it, so it was easy for me to get bullied on. But I've been bullied easily because my hair, mainly. It's mainly been my hair. It's mainly been my religion, me serving God. That's always been a problem for somebody. And it's just been like I've been through life. It's wherever somewhere new I go, whether it's a new school or a new neighborhood, there's always somebody who feels some type of way about me, and they don't even have to know me. And administrators themselves, they even, you know, they pick on me just for certain, small things. And I just learned to live through it. And I've been picked on, and people used to want to get in fights with me. And it's just been a lot of drama. And as I try to get further away from it, it's when they get really angry and mad and more mad. And even the administrators, it wouldn't be like, they wouldn't really, you know, be more connected and try to, you know, move and help us. And that's most of the problem this generation. We don't have much help, especially because social media, and that's how most fights start. Most people, they go on social media, send certain messages, and then somebody say the wrong thing, and somebody's ready to fight, somebody ready to take it to a different level, and so.
So that's it really starts a lot of times like that. And do you tell teachers when this is going on?
I tell teachers, and most of my teachers, they just say, get off of the online.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Then when you get off online, then they start to confront you face to face and start giving you mean looks and say mean things and start, you know, like pulling your clothes or something. And then, you know, more things get physical.
Gosh. Well, and Trevor, you kind of grew up in a different time before the social media. You know, what is your experience with this?
Well, I mean, I think coming up as from a young man's perspective, a lot of young boys get being a man mixed up with aggression, you know? So you feel like if you can scare somebody or seem like the tough guy, that makes you the cool guy, the big man. So, you know, I ran into that coming up, but my thing was, I hate to say it, I learned how to box. That's one way to cope. But, you know, violence and violence doesn't usually help. But sometimes you have to get somebody up off you.
Yeah. When carrying the boxing gloves probably helped.
That helps.
That would
right.
be a deterrent.
And that did help because they knew, you know what, he's not having it. I know he wears the glasses and all that good stuff, but, you know, he's not having it. And I also got I got a sense of humor about it.
Yeah.
So a
that's
lot of things.
Really key,
yeah.
I think. Don't you think? A sense of humor, being able to laugh.
Because it'll start with jokes, and they're trying to be condescending and come down on you. But when they see that your jokes tend to be a little bit more, you know, they know, okay, he got me, you know. So they'll leave you alone. So that was kind of my thing. I was witty. I wasn't a mean person at all, but I'm not going to let you run over me either.
Right.
So most times I would let them know, you know, hey, you don't want to go there, man. You know, maybe some jokes will go back and forth, but if it went too far, I would let them know, you know, I'm not going to be the one to be bullied, you
know.
But, you know, coming up, they got an understanding that I was confident in who I was and that, you know, I wasn't going for it. But before that, I did still have an issue with that fitting in.
Yeah.
You know? So, you know, I think it takes for young people to understand who they are and whose they are.
Right.
When you understand whose you are, like she said, we were made in God's image, there's nothing anybody can tell me at that point. Because if I'm made in God's image, there's none greater. So that means I'm great.
Yeah.
No matter what you say. So at the end of the day, understanding that if you continue, it starts to feel to me that it may be something in you that doesn't like what's in me.
Yeah.
Because this is spiritual warfare we're under right now. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So once you break that spell yourself, you can break it in others because they'll see that, you know what, they're not really falling for this whole make them feel bad about themselves or who they are thing, you
right.
know? So that person that may be delivering it may not even understand what's using them, you know
right.
what I mean? But that thing that's using them understands what's using me.
Yeah.
So they'll back down. And that's how it played out.
Well, do you think, I mean, I feel like every time I turn on the TV now or the news, mm-hmm. there's a bullying. I mean, it's like rampant.
It is.
Do you think it's worse now? Or do you think it has always been around, but we just hear about it more?
It's worse.
Do you think it's worse?
The reason why.
People are angry.
People are angry. But like I said, look at the video games we play.
Yeah.
Our kids play. Every video game I see is about somebody getting shot, somebody getting beat up. They're watching wrestling. They're coming home and trying it on their siblings. Every time I turn on the news, somebody's got shot. Somebody's done this. You listen to the music. I can't listen to the music in my car mm-hmm. with my daughter without hearing something explicit, something about some violence or things of that nature. We're bombarded with it. Television shows, reality shows, they're fighting all the time.
Yeah.
You see this, and they call it a reality show, so you get the idea that it's reality,
right.
but it's not. And there are good people out here doing good things. And I think what's happening these days, and the reason why it's worse, is because it's the lack of God. The absence of God is only going to show itself as you see it right now. So the solution, I think, is those people of God need to stand up and let their light shine. And show that there are good things like stations and shows like this.
Yeah.
People need to see more of it. You can only go as far as you can see. So when they see things like that, things like your show, people like us who are actually showing you how to walk that walk, they'll know that this world isn't as bad as we think it is. We just have to be the start of the change.
Now, you're doing some things in the community to try to deal with some of the solutions
yes, ma'am.
Of the problems. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, I actually host a television show called The Vadio Show, and the VA in there, of course, is for Virginia because we're from this area, but it also stands for visual activists. Because again, I feel like you can only go as far as you can see. So
yeah,
we want to show
good.
You more. So what we do with the show is everything that I just explained, we seek out those people who are doing good things and we broadcast that, we cover that. We bring children on, we bring people on the show that have good things to say.
Yeah.
If there's issues in a community, whether it be domestic violence, whether it be race issues, whatever it may be, we don't see it as taboo. We face it head on, we talk about it, and we find solutions. And that's what the show is based on. It's a community show that's made for community people. You know, we have some celebrities that come on, but mostly it's community.
Like Aisley, Bosier.
Yeah, like those type celebrity people. So
give us an example about something good that's going on, because I think that's the other thing we hear about
okay,
all the night. We need
right.
to hear about the good stuff.
Well, most recently we were talking about bullying. There was Parents Against Bullying came together and did a 1,000 youth march in Newport News,
and
they had a lot of kids marching against bullying. There's
all age groups.
All age groups.
Who did y'all organize
Parents
that?
Against Bullying.
Oh, they
yeah. The lady's name is Shantae. I think I forgot her last name, but Shantae. I'm sorry. She put it together, and a couple other people. The mayor of Newport News came out. He made I think last month Anti-Bullying Month.
Yeah.
So that happened, and a lot of people may not have known about
yeah,
it, but
I didn't
that's
even
going
hear about
on.
That. Did you march?
Yeah, I did.
Did mm-hmm. you?
There are also good things like what we did was a lot of problems that we have in our communities, the lack of jobs and things of that nature.
Mm.
So what we do is we want to show people how unity works. We are sponsored by Hampton Roads Transit. So what we did was we got local businesses together, and they have a hard time staying open because of advertising. People don't know they're there. So we got local businesses together, put our monies together, and wrapped an HRT bus.
Oh,
so that way you got constant advertising.
Yeah.
That thing that's going on. There's events on against domestic violence that are happening
yeah.
all over. So it's people rising up and marching against things and talking about things, pulling people together. But it seems as if when it comes to news, we only kind of go to who got
right.
shot.
Right.
But there are people who are fighting that. There's always going to be evil out here.
Yeah.
But as long as you know there's good as well, we got to even the playing field. as long as you know that's happening and we become that in crowd, then, you know, it'll be a better place to live, at least in the community here that we're doing it, you know?
Yeah.
And hopefully it can become contagious.
Well, and Aisley, what about, what are the schools doing? Like, in your school, are they addressing some of these issues or having, you know, gatherings where they talk about this? Because a lot of it, like you said, it's mm-hmm. having these conversations mm-hmm. and the unifying people and having them come together.
Yeah.
Are they doing that?
In the administrations and the school districts, they talk about bullying and they talk about how they're against it and they do Spirit Week about it, like you wear orange to represent no bullying or shades to shade out bullying.
Oh, that's a good one.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah. So everyone wears sunglasses?
Yeah, you wear sunglasses.
That's nice.
And most of the time, they do something about it. But if it's like internet problems, then they'll say like it's out of their reach because it's internet and social media. And sometimes there's like a certain point where they can't go of bullying. Like if they tell their parents, the parents can get involved too.
Yeah.
And sometimes the administration, they only do like but so much because they can. And sometimes I tell them and they tell me the same thing, to just tell my parents or to avoid them or to go to another group of friends. And even when you do that, it's still a problem. Because then the opponent, it gets mad. They get mad, and they, you know, they just go even harder and bully even more. And then school districts, they just do but so much.
Well, are you allowed to go into other schools? Have you been invited to go to schools and talk about this?
Yes, I have been invited to a couple schools to go talk to the young boys and girls about bullying and self-esteem and how you have your own self-confidence and you're made in God's likeness, so you shouldn't be worried about anything. And I went to other schools to talk about education and the importance of reading and writing and practicing your words and telling them how social media can kind of dumb you down just from texting, and then it slows down your brain.
Yeah, not complete sentences for starters. Not good punctuation.
Like auto-correct, and you don't really get to fix your own word.
Yeah.
It's just correcting it on its own. And you don't really get that full lesson in your brain.
That's amazing. So you're talking about all that to the other kids. Are they receptive? Is it a dialogue, or like do they ask questions?
I like to be interactive with the other kids because I wouldn't want to be in an assembly where there's just somebody who's talking and talking and talking and we're just sitting there. So I like to be interactive and like bring a beach ball or something and throw it out, and whoever catch it, they answer a question or they ask a question. And at the end of each assembly, I ask them a question of how they're feeling or how they should feel now. And they answer the questions, they ask questions, and I get email. When I get home, I have a ton of emails saying thank
that
you.
That is
and
amazing.
They hope I come back, so.
You must be so, your parents have got to be so proud. I'm so proud of you.
I mean,
you've got more books to write. So we're about to close out, but tell people how they can get your book.
I have this website, it's called www.aisleysays.com, and you can order books there, and we have products, and we have different things that you can buy for little girls, and we have books. It's going to be a lot more books, and we have like tutus for the girls and like bows and a lot of things.
Well, I cannot thank you enough for coming out here today, and I can't wait to read your book. So I've been joined by Aisley Bosier and Trevor Lucas, and the book is I Am Not the Hair I Wear. And good luck to you both, and thank you so much for spending this time
with us today, talking
about important things. I'm Ann Farrell Tata. This is Joy in Our Town. Thank you. We'll see you next time.
This program has been sponsored by the Trinity Broadcasting Network and made possible by your telethon dollars. Your continual support can keep Joy in Our Town brought to your home every day. So write Joy in Our Town, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711.